ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the wedding reception honoring Katie and Jason on this sunny day, April 7th, 2018. My name is Sean. I'm going to be your DJ for this evening. And next up is the grand introductions of the family and the wedding party. So everyone get excited and get ready to make some noise as we start bringing them in. First up are Katie's grandmothers, Miss Faye Tinder and Miss Helen Goplerud.
Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me.
Please welcome Katie's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Brad and Donna Goplerud. Next up are Jason's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Nate and Kathy Smith. Put your hands together for the Flower Girls, Ava and Emma. First up for the bridal party, Kenny Larson, Tim Adelman, and Anna Bright. Put your hands together for co-maid of honor, Mary Hershauer with best man Bart Northrup. Let's hear it for co-maid of honor Jackie Hershauer and best man Jason Penner. And last but not least, co-maid of honor, Carly Hershauer, coming down with the best man, Adam Smith. Ladies and gentlemen, stand up. Here they are celebrating their life journey together on April 7th, 2018. Your newlyweds, your bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Katie Smith! Now the time-honored tradition of the cutting of the wedding cake. And we have a song that's very near and dear to Katie and Jason's hearts, something that they grew up to listening to, just very special to them. So here it is.
Not to worry. Well, hello, everyone. I'm Brad Goplerud, the father of the bride and the proudest man in this room. Those of you who know me can attest I'm a man of few words, but also a man of my word. So rest assured, I won't be dragging this on and on. First of all, a very warm welcome to family and friends who have made the journey near and far to celebrate this wonderful occasion and making Katie and Jason feel so loved and blessed. Ladies and gentlemen of the wedding party, thank you for standing up and supporting Katie and Jason and helping make this day so memorable and special. A huge thanks to Faye Tinder for all your help and craftiness in creating all the flowers and decorations, and to Marcia Hershauer for you keeping your assistance and organizational skills, and mostly for helping keep Donna sane. To Nate and Kathy Smith, thank you for being such a wonderful, fun, caring couple and for raising such an outstanding, loving son. I look forward to us being one big, happy, extended family. And Donna, I can't say enough about you, but I'm limited after all. I gave him my word. So thank you for all the planning, coordinating, organizing, calling, hand-holding, reminding, love, and in devotion, and giving yourself more than 100% to ensure that Katie would have everything. Everything that she requires for the wedding and for life in general. But that's you, and I'm so grateful each and every day for you. We made it here today. Undefeated and undivided. And we used to think that remodeling and hanging wallpaper was a test of a marriage. Katie, you have been the focus of your mother's and my life for the past 24 years. We have tried to instill in you high values, morals, independence, a strong work ethic, compassion, empathy, wisdom, and common sense. You've demonstrated that you have got it. You've shown wisdom beyond your years. Coupled with your mom's grace, beauty, charm, and brains, it's easy to see why all your friends, coworkers, and everyone around you think so highly of you. Continue being you, optimistic, seeing the good in everyone, and seeing a glass half full. Excuse me. I'm also so happy you will be carrying on our love of nature and the outdoors. I'm thankful you will be sharing camping, fishing, hiking with your new husband. I hope you're ready for the adventure, Jason. So here we are, this day. Quite frankly, a day I'm not sure any dad is truly prepared for, giving your daughter's future, care, and trust over to another. Jason, you must be awfully special because Katie has never been easily impressed. So you must be a hell of a guy. you two are meant for each other. I mean, what are the odds that two youngsters would meet way up in eastern Michigan in a little town of Oscoda, both with strong Christian values, both with wacky senses of humor, and both who march to a different drummer and not following the herd. And Jason, I know that you love Katie dearly and will do anything for her, but I feel I just need to warn you of a few things. First of all, your life will now be catch and release. This involves any creature that crawls, creeps, slithers, walks, hops, or flies. Inside or outside, you are entering a no-kill zone. And two, you are now a nature wrangler slash road crew slash traffic control for turtles, geese, ducks, anything crossing the road. You will assure their safe crossing. Three, recycling will be a major part of your life now. Think long and hard before just tossing something into the garbage. Or be prepared for a stern environmental impact statement. And four, when she's hungry, feed her. You don't want to see hangry. Learn what signs to watch out for and learn how to cook. And five, lastly, she comes by her stubbornness honestly. We are Norwegian. And as they say, you can always tell a Norwegian, but you just can't tell them much. And again, I know you two are meant for each other, so just keep loving each other, living for each other, and talking to each other. That talking part shouldn't be a problem, since I don't know of two people who can talk so much in a day, every day, as much as you two do. As mentioned earlier, Donna and I have done the best we could for 24 years, and I think Katie has turned out pretty darned well. The next 24 plus are up to you. And I'm going to leave you with four little words. Just don't mess this up. Now, without further delay, let's get this party started. Everyone stand, raise your glasses to the new couple, Jason and Katie Smith. Dilly dilly. Blessing this evening, we're going to give it over to Jason's dad, Mr. Nate Smith.
Well, how do you follow that? Wow. You know, it's funny you said that because I remember talking to Jason shortly after they met, and I just could tell that Katie was a keeper. And I said to Jason, don't screw this up. This girl is a keeper, so I'm so glad that you made that decision and were able to work that out. Let's put our heads together. Heavenly Father, we are so grateful for this event, this coming together, these two people by your hand. I'm just absolutely assured that this is a God thing and has been from the beginning. Otherwise, they would have never met in Oscoda. And I am so grateful that they came together and that these two families have come together. We've had such a good time getting to know one another and to be here. And we are so grateful for all the people that made the effort to come to this event from long distances and to be here to support this family. And we'll continue to support this couple as they go on their life journey, and we'll need our love and help and support as that goes on, because there will be difficult times. And we just ask you, Lord, to remain in the center of their relationship, and we just ask you to be with all the people as they head home after this. Keep them safe. Be sure that this will be an enjoyable evening and a good time for all. And we just thank you for all that you've done to bring this couple together. Amen.
Before you leave tonight, make sure you sign one of the Jenga pieces. You may have already done it, just so they
So Katie and Jason have some nice keepsakes. We're also going to have a backdrop open, and there's lots of funny props, so get some funny pictures tonight. And oh, did I hear people clinking? Okay, you can kiss this time. Go ahead, kiss this time. So here's what we're going to do. That's going to be the last time the clinking of the glasses makes Katie and Jason kiss tonight. As you can see, we've got kind of a green theme going on. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a putt for a kiss. So if you want to see them kiss, you're going to have to sink a putt. Now, if you can do like a short putt, and they'll do a little kiss, or you can do a long putt, and it'll be a longer kiss. So is there... I promise, dessert's on its way. We're going to go into our next round of toasts. And we're going to start off with the best man. You ready, everyone? Here we go. We're going to hand it over to Mr. Adam Smith.
Hello. How's everybody doing? Oh, I don't think you're excited enough to be here. I want everybody to make some noise. Oh, yeah. In case you haven't figured it out, I'm Adam. I'm his brother. Best man, hello. I want to welcome everyone here and just thank you all so much for coming out to support these two. You know, I've known my brother almost my whole life, you know, since he was born. You know, so it's pretty special to see him have grown up like this. And it's awesome to see you have met someone who is your equal in humor and silliness, point being. But I've been talking to people, and it seems like people have come from all over the place. So I'm curious, just a little crowd participation here. Raise your hand if you traveled more than 50 miles to be here. Okay, 100 miles. 150? 200, 300, 400, 500. I think you get the point. People, come on. People love you guys, and you are incredibly special. And it also just proves the point that people will do anything for a free meal around here. Jeez. In fact, I've been performing in wedding bands myself for about 10 years now, and I think this will be only about the third time I've actually gotten a piece of wedding cake in the last decade. So somebody save me an extra. Pull up my bullet points here. Just one more time again. I want everybody to make a big noise for this couple. If you love them, make a noise. Oh, yeah. Breathe that in. You probably won't ever hear it again. But seriously, Katie, I want to take the time to welcome you into the family. I've never had a sister, so that's pretty cool. So welcome, and like I said, it's so special to have someone who's as weird as we are. And, you know, I'm sure you'll fit right in. I already know you do. Let's see here. Sorry, I'm... Despite my performance, I am a terrible speech giver. Anyway, let's see. I wrote this all out. Anyway, when I heard Jason had popped the question, I would kind of went into full big brother mode. You know, I was like, who's this girl who's trying to weasel it her way into my little brother's heart? You know, oh. But seriously, when I met these two together, I was like, oh, I get it. You know, we've been taking pictures right before this, and the two of them can't even make a serious face at one another. It's just, which is so appropriate, because if, exactly. I'm sure most of you have met Jason before. And for those of you who haven't, most of our childhood was spent just making faces at each other and making noise until we laughed. This was usually how we entertained ourselves on road trips and things, but not in the backseat of the car. It was usually in public places, just for the whole point of embarrassing our mother. which we still do. Exactly.
People are watching.
And the fact that I see you two doing this in public now is so special to my heart. Please don't ever stop doing that, because it's something that binds you two together, and it's something that bonds y'all together, and laughter and humor is so important to love and relationships. It'll get you through anything at all. In fact, here's some big brotherly advice, because I can. don't worry, I'll keep it clean. First of all, make sure you take the time to stop and listen to one another, because arguments will arise. They do. Am I right? Anybody married? Yeah. They happen. And you can just bicker at one another, and here's my argument, and here's my argument, and here's my argument. But the truth of the matter is, you won't actually understand each other until you're listening. And I know you two seem to have this incredible soulmate connection. It's kind of amazing that you went all the way to Oscoda, Michigan to, like, go both of you to these jobs that are like, well, I guess I could go to the middle of nowhere. They don't even have a grocery store there. but, you know... Exactly. I'm sorry. They had the convenience store. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Family Fair. The Walmart is three towns over. It's small. but the fact that you went there and met your soulmate is kind of incredible. But still, take time to listen to each other. For example, you know, like, if you're buying furniture or something, you know, like, even when Jason is convinced that that giant beanbag couch is totally the one to get, and you're like, no, the big egg chairs from Men in Black are the ones we're getting because they're cool, right? Oh, yeah. But here's the thing. You can argue that all day long, but what you don't realize is those egg chairs are terrible for snuggling. They're really awful. They're just uncomfortable to sit in, too. They're really small and terrible. And those beanbag chairs are actually really comfortable. But anyway, point aside, I digress. Have patience with one another. Jason, it runs in the family, so I feel comfortable saying this. Jason moves slower than most people. This whole table and anyone who's ever golfed with him, lived with him, been eaten with him. even we went to lunch earlier today and he was still the last one to finish. He eats his peas one at a time, basically. So have patience with this boy and have patience with each other. Take time for intimate moments. And I know it's silly, you know, you look at each other and all you want to do is, you know, have a good laugh because it's, you know, awkward and uncomfortable to stare into one another's eyes. But seriously, take the time to do that. Take time to admire one another. Make space in your heart for one another as well. Because, you know, as Christians, we say, make room in your heart for Jesus, because you can't have a relationship with Christ without making room for him. So make room for one another, because that's just as important, because you two are a living example of his love. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I'm not done yet, though. Yeah. I also want to say, don't ever not make out like teenagers. Find the time to have fun with each other like that. For God's sake, you're married now. Go have fun. And please, don't stop laughing and being silly with one another, because that's really more important than anything else in the world. Now, I once heard it said that the best speeches are ones that start funny, end funny, and don't have too much in the middle. And I've already well surpassed that by now. So I would like to take you out on a toast. This one is from a writer named Ogden Nash. To keep your marriage brimming with love in the wedding cup. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. Y'all, please raise your glasses to Jason and Katie. Now kiss her.
Thank you very much to our best man, Adam. And we don't have one, we've got three maids of honors. And they're all going to give a toast together. So we've got Mary, Jackie, and Carly.
Hello, everyone. We're going to stay here because this table is a little comfort thing. So I hope you don't mind. I want to welcome everyone here and hope you guys are enjoying yourselves so far. I also want to thank everyone who traveled both near and far for this special day. I know it means a lot to Katie and Jason that you guys are here, so thanks for that. I'm Carly, and these are my sisters, Jackie and Mary, and we are Katie's cousins. Although Katie has always been more like a sister to us, so. Okay, so where to begin? So Katie and I are 9 months apart. So we've been around each other for the majority of our lives. Our relationship started out a little rocky with me beating up on you as a baby. So, but I was just trying to make you strong. So, and I think it worked. So you're welcome. You're welcome. Like I said earlier, Katie has always been more like a sister to us. She never even wanted to leave our house as kids. She would hide when her parents would call her name to leave. That was a fun little game. Or she would always want to join in on all of our catty sister fights, which there were many, because she felt left out on all the fun. Yeah. I have so many great memories with Katie, from the endless pool parties in her backyard to creating a secret mermaid language in the middle of Paradise Lake. Yeah, don't ask. Going to concerts or live bands and bars. Our long phone conversations in college that would turn into mini therapy sessions, making gingerbread houses every Christmas, rollerblading in the city with one set of rollerblades. Try doing that, yeah. Watching stupid YouTube videos for hours on end, and so much more. See, this is the part where I would give you some great marital advice, but I'm single and live with my parents, so yeah. Thank you. But seriously, Katie, it's never a dull moment with you, so, and I can't wait to continue the memories in the future.
So like Carly said, there never really is a dull moment with Katie. Growing up and to this day, I looked up to Katie a lot. She's caring, funny, adventurous, not afraid to be herself, and always someone I can go to about anything. I have way too many great memories to share, all of them, so I just want to share one of my favorites. When I was younger, I thought Katie was so great that I wanted to do everything she did. This included sitting next to her at every single meal, liking the color yellow because she liked yellow, and following her at every family party. Katie was not really a big fan of this, so she didn't want me to sit next to her or like the color yellow or to follow her anywhere, but I did it anyways. Eventually, I think she either got used to it or just started to ignore me, and I realized I didn't have to do everything she did I could like the color blue, too. I still remember her getting mad about all those things, and I love looking back and watching the home videos of that happening and laughing at all those times. I know you feel really guilty about it, but I want to tell you today that I forgive you. And I still think you're really great. And then, before I pass the mic to Mary, I do have one more special message. Gracias para vivir en la casa, en la escuela, en Azul Mercado. Tienes con beber en las fuerzas. Gracias. All right. Hola. Well, I've known you my entire life, and it almost seems like yesterday we were diving at the bottom of your pool for the rings, or catching toads, or building those enormous car towns with chalk on your driveway or in your parents' flower bed. I'm sure they appreciated that. Or making those silent films in the camper. Yeah, I still have those. And now here we are watching you get married to your other half. And I cannot express in words how proud I am and excited I am for you. And I still remember in eighth grade when I wrote a paper about you and saying how you were my role model. And of course, that still stays true. You have always taught me the importance of being true to yourself and never be afraid to be weird. It makes life more interesting. Yammy, yammy. Thank you, Miss Tammy. And I just love our bond and how we could just look at each other and just make a weird noise or just embrace. And just quoting the most random YouTube videos. The list goes on. And people have no idea what we're talking about most of the time, but I love that. And so thank you for being my third sister and being one of my best friends. I love you more than words can say, and Jason got really lucky to have you as a wife. Now, Jason. We had no idea what to expect when we found out we were going to meet you. Was he going to be quiet? Was he going to be normal? We were wrong. You instantly talked to us, and we knew why Katie was so excited to introduce you to us. Even though we haven't known you a lifetime, we feel like you have because you fit so well into the family. We couldn't make someone more perfect for Katie, and we're so happy to officially have you in the family today. So, since we have known Katie for almost her entire lifetime, we have put together some things you should know about life with Katie. And, Brad, we had some similar ideas. She's very independent. She doesn't need your help blowing out her candles or opening her presents, but she'll always be there when you need help with that. She needs to be fed when hungry. Like Brad said, hangriness runs in our family, and you don't want us to get to that point. You can ask our dads. Her desk may never be clean, but that's where the best homemade cards are made, so just let it be. She gives great advice and also is a great listener. If you need a good laugh, she never fails. And then exploring the outdoors and taking as many adventures as you can together. Learn how to make her coffee in the morning in case she's running late. And then Katie is also the best bargain shopper we know. She's the definition of balling on a budget. Katie will teach you to really appreciate nature and how important it is to take care of our planet. Don't be surprised if she yells at you for leaving the water running too long. Or if there happens to be, say, a giant wasp buzzing around in your apartment, she would advise you not to kill it. but to set it free, because killing a bug is a sin in her eyes. And if she makes a random noise, that's completely normal. Just go with it. But Jason, we know you'll make a noise back at her, so it's fine. And finally, most importantly, don't forget to recycle. We are so excited for the two of you to start your journey together. We love you both, and we wish you a lifetime of happiness. So everyone, grab a glass, and let's cheers to the happy couple. Yeah. Cheers! Dilly dilly.
Just come on down, and we'll give you the microphone, or tell a story, or tell a funny joke, and then we're gonna start dancing. So here you go, guys.
Hi, everybody. So I am a friend of Katie G, and actually the person that I have known for the longest in this room is actually Carly. She was the very first friend that I ever made in university. I promptly transferred from that university. I'm just kidding. Sorry. No, I walked into their room and I asked them where the bubbler was, and they made fun of me because they're from Illinois and the Bears suck. So, a bubbler is what water comes out of and you drink it. It's how you stay hydrated. So then I went to UWSP, and the second and third people that I met at university were Katie and Kenny, and they were like, hey, you know my cousin? And I was like, oh yeah, I do. No, it's okay. Carly and I are friends now. We put on makeup together, so we're bonded for life. So Katie, G, and I have a lot of interests, and that's, I think, when we became really close, was doing summer field work in northern Wisconsin. And yeah, that was really fun. So first of all, we were really excited that we were able to do field work. And the day that the professor told us that we were able to conduct our own research project, we ran down three flights of stairs and then just screamed in the stairwell, and then realized we should stop screaming in the stairwell, and we went outside and continued to scream. So go science. It really fires you up. So if anybody has ever been to northern Wisconsin during the summer, they know that there are a lot of ticks. We both were on doxycycline for Lyme disease. Every single day for 12 weeks at 7 a.m., we would check 30 traps for small mammals, which is a very bonding experience, ergo I'm here. And we normally didn't catch anything. And normally, over half the time, the bears were destroyed by, or the traps were destroyed by bears, ruined that one. They were claw marks and ripped open and stuff like that. And my professor said, I used to use, collapsible traps when I was an undergrad. And I was like, they're not collapsible, they're all destroyed. Thank you. So bears are bad. There was one time that we actually ran into a bear while we were checking a trap, and we just heard a big fat thing running through the forest, crashing around, and we stopped, and we watched the bear run past, and they were we should have made a noise. But we didn't. And then I started walking. So they're all in a line, so we were standing at one trap, and we decided, I started walking to the next trap. And Katie was like, no, Anna, that was a big black bear. We're going to leave. I was like, you're right. We shouldn't continue working because there's a bear near us. So we went home, which is different from the next time we ran into a bear. I said, okay, you take the van back to the field station. I'm just going to run back because it's a 5K. I got to get my training in, cardio. So I saw her drive away in the field vehicle, and she got 400 meters away. And I was like, that's interesting. She stopped, whatever, probably taking a picture of a bug. And I ran up to the van, and by this time she had parked the van in the middle of this dirt road, and she got out and she's like, get in the car. And I was like, oh, okay, sure. I was just gonna run, okay, sure. She's like, get in the car. And I was like, why? She's like, bears, there are bears, get in the car. So she's outside the driver's seat, and so I was like, oh, I'll ride shotgun, right? So I calmly walk to the passenger seat. By now she's already in the car and locked the doors. She locked the doors before I was in the car. So I was like, hey, knocking on the window. I was like, Katie, could you open the door? And she was making weird noises. Yeah. Like, blah, 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 like pushing all the buttons. And I like can see her across pushing all the buttons. I'm like, the unlock one. And she's like, there's a mom and two cubs. And I was like, open the door. And so then she pushed so many buttons so quickly that I could not get in the van. So she gave up on the buttons and jumped into the passenger seat and put both hands on the window, like an inch away from my face, and just cried. She was like, I'm so sorry, you're gonna die. So, I didn't die. I'm here. Thank you. So, like, my advice is like, good luck. That's all I got. And you're screwed.
Thanks.
And so Kenny is gonna share a beautiful Swedish proverb. And my partner's Turkish, and Turkish isn't beautiful. So here's the proverb, and it makes as much sense as he does. Before you love, learn to walk in the snow without leaving footprints. Think about it.
Hey, I'm Kenny. I do have a female name. It's Katie. We're friends from college, and I would describe everything that Katie and I do as organized chaos. Something or chaos that becomes organized, or like chaos or organization that becomes chaotic, something along those lines. Like one of the first things that we did together was we got cookies and then we burnt them in the microwave and then we glued them to people's doors at 2 a.m. in the dorm. That's one example. And there's this thing called slothing. And it's this, you go up on a tree, you hang on a branch like a sloth does. But one time I did that, and was it you who shook the tree and I fell? And Katie does this thing. This is somewhat different. This is how she responds to bad things that are funny. She goes, she has this response where she's like, did that happen? Did that really happen? And then like she gets over it, like that she's afraid for you, and then she just laughs. Like one time I was biking home from the library at 10:30 a.m. and we were roommates at the time. So I was biking home and then a car hit me. And then I put my chains back on my bike and I finished biking home and I get home and I like, Katie, wake up! And I was like shaking because of the adrenaline, and I was like, I got hit by a car on my way. And Katie was like, really? And then it was quiet, and she was like, the third time this happened, again at 10:30 at night, coming home from the library, went to our locker room. We had a cross-country locker room, and the door was cracked open, and there was someone that shouldn't have been in the locker room, and they scared me, and they shouldn't have been there, and it was scary, but it was fine. We had a nice, so I immediately was like, I need to call Katie. Like, she'll help me calm down. So I call her. She's like, oh, I'm here studying. So I run over and I'm like, Katie, there was someone in the locker room. And like, I told her and she was like, really? Like, every time something bad happens, like, she cares so much for you, but she always can laugh at things, no matter how, and it's nice because like, you also laugh at it and then it makes you feel better because you're like, something bad happened, but it was funny. Okay, then now let's fix it. And then we can laugh at it again. And the Swedish proverb is, share joy is double the happiness, and shared sorrow is half the sorrow. Yeah, Swedish proverb. I love you. Good luck. You don't need luck, but...
I would also like to say that Anna is defending her thesis next week, so just give her an extra pump up for that. Yeah, that's really exciting because she's really smart.
Highway run into the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round, round my mind. Restless hearts sleep alone tonight. I'm sending Jason. And the longest song in the world.
That was a great, great job. Let's give it up for Adam, too. And again, congratulations, Jason and Katie. So, Jason, yeah, you can go have a seat now. And this next person has been waiting many, many years for this day when he can dance with his daughter on her wedding day. So Brad, come on down.
For the single ladies. Anyone else?
Ooh,
not yet. I got a drum roll, Katie. Hold on. So, single ladies, count of three. It's coming soon. One, two, another one for your ladies.